Well, hello there. I can barely hear myself.
Mic check over here. Mic check. Mic check 1-2. Mic check 1-2.
I can't hear Justice at all.
Mic check 1-2. Mic check 1-2.
Hooray, technical difficulties.
Mic check 1-2. Okay, I can hear myself now. Mic check 1-2.
Still can't hear you, Justice. And I can kind of hear myself.
Also, there is no sitting on the rail. The back rail.
You're listening to a mic check.
There's no standing on your chairs. There's no sitting on the back of your chairs. You know what the seats are for? Your butts. Put your butts on the seat.
Let's see. Oh, hey, that works a lot better. For me, at least.
Put your meat on the seat. Pretend you're
Buzz.
Right now, if you can hear me, we are getting ready for Philadelphia versus Rocky Mountain, the second bout, the second whoop the sanction bout of RollerCon 2012. I am here with Tara Armoff, who is currently having her mic checked up.
So many technical difficulties. Okay. And blowing out Justice's eardrums in the process.
Yes, I'm capable of hearing Tara Armoff. That's for certain. Right now, teams are in the equipment check. Earlier today, Rocky Mountain defeated Minnesota in a pretty close game.
That's right. The score on that was 139-114 in favor of Rocky.
So Rocky looking to make it two for RollerCon.
We need assistance in a lot of departments, whether it's the Dick's departments.
Rocky Mountain is playing all of their games at RollerCon today, which I think is really smart.
Playing smart is good.
Exactly. Denver will be here tomorrow, playing on both Saturday and Sunday. We also have games from Rose City. Tomorrow we'll be playing Philly at 12:15. 3:15 is Philly versus Minnesota. 7 p.m. Rose City versus Denver. And then the last and only game on Sunday, 12:15, Denver versus Minnesota. All times are Pacific.
Pacific or specific?
All times out here in the West Coast.
And let's give a quick update of the rosters for this game. For the 5280 Fight Club, that would be Rocky Mountain. We have number 10, RoboFlow. Number 122, Castrator. Number 202, Frida Beater. Number 3, Catholic Crew Girl. Number 30, Red Eye. Number 37, blah, blah, blah. Number 378, Toxic Tonic. Number 422, Gagan. Number 719, Alpha Q Up.
That's right.
Nice.
Good luck with that one.
Nice. Oh, I'm going to screw that up big time. Number 75, Bijou Blanc Bleu.
Bijou Black and Blue.
Black and Blue. See, I'm so bad. 86, Assault and Peppa. 88, She Who Cannot Be Named. Number 9, Amanda Jamadinha. Number 99, Make You Pay. And M80, Sweet Mary Payne.
And we'll get the Phillies roster on a timeout here, so we're getting ready to start here.
As we were saying earlier, the first game, I like watching teams take the jammer line 10 minutes before the game starts. Make sure they're already there. We are in action now. Sweet Mary Payne jamming for Rocky Mountain. Have not seen Philly's jammer from our angle yet. It's like V-Diva. V-Diva is the first new jammer this game. Not too far behind, though. Sweet Mary Payne about straight away behind. Coming around for first scoring pass in the game is V-Diva.
And it looks like we're getting kind of a spread out pack. Rocky trying to take up the front as much as possible. V-Diva coming through, picking up a point or two.
Yeah, if I could roll from Philly there to get to run away from at the front of the pack, making sure that V-Diva could only get that one. So Philly will draw first blood. Here with a point.
At one lonely point.
Exactly. On the jam line now, Teflon Donna of Team USA for Philly. And it is Toxic Tonic. We hadn't seen before a jammer before this RollerCon, but it was very effective in the first game against Minnesota.
That's right. Helen Wheels is bench coaching for yes. Rocky this weekend, it looks like. And it's interesting to watch her adjust the lineups as the game goes on. She's of course, she would know this team fairly well based on her experience in the derbies in general. And it looks like Rocky is out and lead jammer.
Toxic lead jammer. Teflon Donna still stuck way in the back, but now it's going to up the outside. Oh. Find some red, but it's going to get passed on 20 feet. But now Toxic is in the pack and scoring.
And gets taken down there in the apex.
Called it just in time, I think. Yeah, no points for Philly. And see what Toxic got.
Lead change already. Rocky with 3 points to Philly's one.
And everybody is very close together on the jammer line here.
Such a cozy jammer line.
That's a Sweet Mary Payne, again, was effective this morning against Minnesota. It was a transfer from last year from Chicago Outfit, also with Gagan. They were very effective in taking Chicago Outfit to number 5 in North Central last year. And this year they're here being a helpful replacements for losses from last year with a deranged Psycho Babble and Echo. But lead jammer this time goes to Philadelphia. That is Mo Payne. And now Sweet Mary Payne stuck behind a wall of blue and black.
And it looks like Shihu going to the box for Rocky.
And Sweet Mary Payne is through the front of the pack. However, Mo Payne, plenty of space to score. She's going to call it quickly to keep that Rocky blocker in the box, Shihu. And it's going to put Philly right back in the lead then. So we got lead change in every single jam of the game so far.
So many lead changes so quickly.
Still pretty low scoring, just 5-3 after about 3 minutes.
Toxic Tonic back on the line for Rocky.
I believe that is Lee Devo, I would say, for can't tell from here. It's kind of we're kind of not a great angle to see all of the jammer names at the back of the pack.
Well, especially since Philly has the red on black numbers, that it's a little difficult back here.
Yeah, I think that is Lee Devo standing out there for Philadelphia. Having a hard time to put Amanda Minio, but she is through for lead jammer.
Yes, I had the joy of playing with V-Diva yesterday in the Amazons versus Short Bus game. And wow, she is a hell of a player. And she is ready to score all of the points.
Try to get an offensive block there, but AJ wasn't having it. But on the inside, V-Diva through, finishes the pass. And for the first time in this game, a team stays in the lead for more than one jam. Still a very low scoring game, though. 9-3 after 4 jams. Philadelphia was doing something interesting early ECE, when they were starting their blockers on the pivot line facing backwards on the knee and then rushing back to the front, or rushing back to the jammer line afterwards, but they appear to have either given up on that strategy or not using it yet.
Another thing that I've been noticing just at RollerCon in general is, at least during the challenge games, there are more and more people occupying the pivot line.
Yes.
It's kind of a breath of fresh air to go back to old school, old style derby from 3 years ago.
Teflon Donna here, one-on-one with Amanda Minio. She is around and she is not lead jammer. She had a no pass, no penalty is being signaled. Rocky gets lead, calls it off. That was Castrator with the call off. Once again, Philly runs the pivot line and
scoreless jam, whatever.
We're about 10 feet from another game happening next to us, and then it's confusing when both whistles go off at the same time.
That's right. That's a Team Cruise and a versus Team Adam going on the adjacent track.
So for the first time here at RollerCon, two simultaneous competition tracks. More Derby. That's M-O-A-R Derby.
All of the Derby, all of the time. It looks like Sweet Mary Payne back on the jammer line for Rocky.
For Billy, going on the side, Shanita Stretcher, I believe, is out there.
I believe you're right.
And she is lead jammer for Philadelphia. Trying to break out of the pack as Sweet Mary Payne shakes off some Philly blocks, but still one to beat at the front of the pack.
Yeah, they're swallowing her back into the pack. But it looks like they're going to get called on out of play. No, maybe not, because she's getting assisted. Oh, she finally makes it out.
And now Shanita is in scoring position. Goes around the outside on one, just one to beat at the front. I'm sorry, two to beat. Last one is free to beat her. Tries to go outside. She does a nice move to keep her on the apex of that, and she won't call it. We'll see if it's in time. So 1 point for Rocky Mountain. So called it a little bit late, but Philly keeps the lead, 12-4 now. Just like the opening game, it seems like almost every jam has been very low scoring. Of course, once you have the power jam, you might expect the scores to go double digit. But so far, neither team either put up a big jam in the early going here.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to see anything hugely scoring until power jams might be popping up. It's going to be on jammer penalties, I do believe.
And lead jammer, V-Diva for Philadelphia. Not too far behind, well, half track behind, is Toxic Tunk. V will be coming in to score first here. She's got one Iraqi in the back. Tries to go outside. Nothing happening. Goes. It's going to call it, I think, with zero. We'll see if he made it past somebody. Yep, 0-0. So V Diva unable to pick one off before Toxic Tunk closed the gap.
Time and points are on Philly's side right now. It's like, it's okay to have the occasional scoreless jam. Who cares?
Especially when you're already winning.
When you're in the lead, they're just going to honey badger it.
Philly's most recent game, a 28-point win over Charm City. Rocky Mountain's most recent game just happened this morning. As we said earlier, they beat Minnesota by a final score of 139-114. So that was a 25-point game. Both of those pretty close. The jammer goes to Rocky Mountain this time. That is castrated.
That's right. And again, Rocky rated ranked number two in the West, WFTDA, beating Minnesota, ranked number two in North Central. Right now going up against number two, Philly, in the Eastern region.
Nice job from the Rocky Mountain there to pick up all four, but Philly did pick off two in there. So another not fully clean win, but it does get Rocky Mountain a little bit closer there. 14-8, still very low scoring as we're almost on the first 10 minutes here.
And another Jammerline start that they love so well. Sweet Mary Payne on the line for Rocky.
On the outside, that is Mo Payne, I believe, number eight for Philadelphia. Right now at the front of the pack behind Amanda Jamadinia, who lets her go on 20 feet, lead jammer Philadelphia. Sweet Mary Payne looking to go inside on heavy flow. Not happening.
Yeah, facing a tough three wall of Philly there. Trying to make it squeak by in front. She finally makes it out.
She's got a long way to go before she gets back to the pack. And Mo Payne is entering right now. Rocky Mountain doing a good runaway here. They have taken the front.
Yes.
And they're managing to, so far, keep all Philly behind them. Still holding them off. Mo Payne waiting for her opportunity. Shoves her blockers towards the red. And finally, they pick one red off. He's got one so far, he's knocked out of bounds, and probably going to call it here. There it is. Calls it off with, I think, just one on the top of here.
Yep. Two.
Did get two.
So 16-8 in favor of Philly.
It's like Tata Tonic once again on the jam line for Rocky Mountain. And they'll be VD on jamming for Philadelphia. Oh, my God, look where they're going. They're going to the pit.
Why? Wow. That is so weird to see.
So now Rocky taking a knee on the pivot line. Philly's going to set up right in the middle to try and not get called an immediate flip back that's going to occur here.
And it looks like Rocky has the pack advantage, all four of their blockers on the track, and they get their jammer through.
No offense there as Tuxtonic was able to just like step through a Fildy wall. However, V-Diva not too far behind here.
Look at the strides on V-Diva as she catches up. Wow.
So it's probably going to hit it in a quick situation here. Tries to go for one, gets it, and calls it very quickly. And she's going to pick up three as she got two ghost points there, affiliate two in the box. So good jam for Rocky Mountain there. They're going to close to within 16 to 11, with about 19 minutes and 40 seconds left in this first half.
Wow, more love for the pivot line.
And now Philly a little bit closer to the
to Rocky.
Length time. Now Rocky goes back on them this
time. Oh, nice. Nice little distraction assist going on.
It worked out pretty well. Teflon Donna got stuck on the inside, and around the outside goes Castrator for Rocky Mountain. Lee's jammer. Teflon Donna still sucking back. Nailed by Amanda Jamadinia.
Oh, AJ. She's so good at that.
Teflon Donna in danger of being lapped now as Castrator is re-entering on her scoring pass. Philly still won the box. Rocky Mountain's box is empty. Oh, big fall here for...
Oh, looks like the cap off of a knee pad came off.
That was Olivia Face fell down, lost her kneecap. Or her knee pad. Her kneecap would have been much worse.
So Teflon Donna out of the pack. However, Castrator gets through and calls it.
Also to the box at the end of that jam was number 99, Make You Pay.
For Rocky.
And looks like Rocky Mountain is...
Is this a tie game?
Tied the game. 16-16. Those teams with two touchdowns and a safety.
Sweet Mary Payne back on the line for Rocky.
It's interesting, the Philly jammer looks like she's lining up behind Sweet Mary Payne.
Yeah, it looked like she was going to try and draft her, but she kind of dodged to the side instead. Sweet Mary Payne fighting her way out of the pack, and she gets lead jammer status.
Oh, and it's a power jam as Philly's jammer, Antidote, who have not seen jamming previously today, makes her debut in the penalty box. So Rocky with the first power jam of the game.
And they're doing the familiar, what I've been calling the Jacob's Ladder. You know, hanging back, letting Philly build a wall, but they're hanging back and getting a no-pack call, getting their jammer through for all of the points.
Now, Philly tries to go to the back, gets a little bit closer to the jammer in doing so, but does have better defense than this timeout.
Well, Sweet Mary Payne still making her way through.
Nice hit here from Shanita Stretcher. It's going to take her down and force her back. Oh, and I...
Ooh, she must have been out of play in the back because she was able to step in front of her and make it through.
She wanted a track cut there. I don't think she got it. And here comes Sweet Mary Payne right through the middle. One to beat now. That's Shanita Stretcher again. Taking her time with it. Shanita's off to the box, looks like.
Yep.
And Rocky Mountain, after being behind for the first 10 minutes here, has opened a little bit of a lead. Now up by points.
as the no way. Increases. Not kittens, points.
14 points as the scoreboard slowly stops updating. We are now at 30 to 16 for Rocky Mountain.
Toxic Tonic back on the jammer line for Rocky Mountain.
Still on the power jam as Antidote to knock out of the box during that last jam. Toxic comes in, falls immediately. Now we have a jammer for Philly. It's just returned. Oh, trips over her own blocker there in the back. But around the outside, Rocky Mountain is lead jammer for Toxic Tonic.
Salt and Pepper getting with AJ there at the front of the pack.
Oh, nice hit from Bob LeBlanc. Takes down Antidote. Now Antidote has to deal with AJ at the front of the pack. Gets around her.
And Make You Pay to the penalty box for Rocky.
And probably a call-off here for Rocky as Philly has one in the box.
Looks like each team has one blocker in the box.
So she calls it and calls it and calls it and then very angrily calls it. And it's called.
She's just gonna keep calling it until they obey, gosh darn it.
34-16, Rocky Mountain puts on four more points onto their lead there. Philly's been stuck at 16 for a little while now. And so it was tied there a while ago, and they've been blanked since. VD who returns to the line for Philadelphia as Jammer. And two, jamming against somebody wearing red.
Which is convenient because it's probably someone from Rocky Mountain.
That's Castrator, but Lee Jammer is V Diva up the inside pretty quickly. Now we see Castrator's out as well. He'll be scoring points first. Ooh, Rocky in a 3-on-1 situation.
Oh, dear. And unfortunately, this is kind of a traditional Rocky thing to do. You know, start out calm, cool, and collected, and then the penalty set in.
Right, so V Diva picks up 4 points on passing one player, 3 to beat her. Rocky Mountain still has 2 in the box. I think they're going to start with 2 in the track on this one.
So Philly's starting to close the gap a little bit with 20 points to Rocky Mountain's 34. 14 minutes, 27 seconds left in the first period of this game.
Looks like that's AJ, and I think Castrator is now blocking for Rocky. On the jam line is a red die.
Yeah, and this is her first time jamming this evening.
Goes quickly to Philadelphia on the 4-2 pack. That is a lead jammer, Teflon Donnie. Red Dye having some trouble here on this lopsided pack favoring Philly.
Yeah, she's kind of left to her own devices there as Rocky tries to wall it up in front. However, Teflon Donna easily gets through, picking up all of the points.
AJ went for the hit, but couldn't quite land it. So Grand Slam Philadelphia, once again, a single-digit game, I think we're going to see here, scoreboard updates. Now 9 points as Teflon Donna coming for more with Rocky Mountain's jammer still stuck in the back.
Yeah, make you pay. Doing a good job for Rocky trying to break up the Philly wall there. Philly, very tenacious. They held her it. They held in Rocky's jammer for a nice long time.
Teflon Donna call here, keeps some Rocky Mountain's players in the box. I think she picked up 4 more on that pass. So, I think it's still a 5-point game, I believe. Yeah, 5-point game, 34-29. It's about 13 minutes left in the first half.
You do math well. I can't do math. I would have just said the score and let people at home count on their fingers and toes to figure out the point differential.
So Rocky's going to get people out of the box here. There's only one left in the box after a lengthy pileup there. This is Castrator Gammon for Rocky Mountain. That is, I think, no pain for Philadelphia.
We'll just say it is for the heck of it.
Yes, that's no pain now behind a wall, red wall of 3, but she's going to get past here for lead, I believe. Oh, I'm sorry, I lost track of somebody. How embarrassing.
Oh, and my gosh.
Back here in reality, the Philadelphia is back in the pack, and it's a power jam for Philadelphia.
All right. We'll see. Ooh.
Oh, that was a power hit from the Sweet Mary Payne.
Yeah, she's living up to her skate name there.
Wow.
And Frida Beater taking a turn.
Good bridge from Rocky Mountain here. Check this out. As they're, even though Phil doesn't have skating at all, they're doing a great job of keeping the jammer in play. Eventually, it got to let her go. But Lee Jammer took her 50 seconds to get Lee Jammer on that one.
The longest jam ever. 50 minutes. Sweet Mary Payne going to the penalty box. Not good for Rocky because she has been one of their dependable jammers in this game. And obviously, she was blocking in this jam. But we'll see how this plays out for Rocky, what they do about this.
I believe that Philly has tied the game on that pass.
Mo Payne coming in.
Once again, Rocky Mountain doing a great job of staying just barely within play and leaving somebody to bridge when they're in danger of splitting.
Oh.
So Bob LaBall dropped backwards by Shanita Stretcher. And this is going to be a Philly lead right now. 5 more for Mo Payne. That's going to give Philly a 39-34 lead. And 20 seconds left in the jam. Chance for more. I'm sorry, it's a 4-point pass. So 38-34.
That's right. This is another lead change right now.
Rocky Mountain has gotten their jammer back. But it's a tough slog right now for both of them. And the jam ends for the jammers, perhaps mercifully.
Looks like Rocky Mountain at 34, Philly 38. 10 minutes, 46 seconds left in the first half. There is a timeout right now.
It's Rocky Mountain's first timeout of the game. So it looks like Rocky Mountain is going to be in an awkward situation when this jam starts, as they have 2 sitting in the box. Philly appears to have their entire contingent out there, and they're already, of course, on the jammer line.
That cozy, cozy, cozy jammer line.
So they'll be hanging out there. I wonder if they're close enough to hear what Rocky's talking about. That'd be funny.
Maybe that's why they're there. It's yeah, like, oh, yeah, we are set up for the next jam, but right, shh, what are they talking about? What are they going to do? V-Diva's like, I don't care. I'm just going to skate.
V-Diva's plan is to lap the opposing blockers multiple times.
All right, looks like Rocky is ready to get back into it.
Only Salt and Pepper and Amanda Jambadinia out there as blockers for Rocky Mountain. Once again, I apologize if we are speaking more about the Rocky Mountain blockers, but it's because we can read their numbers from where we are. I can see at the back here for the Liberty Bells, this heavy flow is on the closest to us. It's hard to tell from our position who the other three blockers are.
Our old eyes can't handle this anymore.
So there appears to be some conversation about penalty boxes on the pivot of things in the box. So
musical penalty box.
I'm assuming that probably somebody still has to go to the box in this one, so they're bringing her back on the track. We'll probably see her go to the box when Rocky gets her out. So Rocky probably gonna be stuck here with two blockers for a while.
And all of the whistles from the other track seem to be happening.
So keep hanging out with us all weekend. We've got four more games. Tomorrow, we were saying the first game is going to be at noon. That is Rose City versus Philadelphia. And then 3:15, Philadelphia versus Minnesota. 7 p.m., Rose City versus Denver. And Sunday has only one game, 12:15 p.m. Pacific time. That's Denver versus Minnesota.
So many games.
I have some friends on Denver who are very psyched to be playing at RollerCon, but not really psyched to be playing at noon on a Sunday.
Yeah, that's going to be a little rough. Mm-hmm.
They'll be the ones drinking the tonic water. So our 1 minute timeout has extended into a 3 minute timeout.
Wow, 3 minutes.
Referees are chatting about something that we will probably never know.
I think they're talking about what they're going to wear to Pants Off Dance Off tonight. Well, that's what I think.
Not pants.
Definitely not pants.
I'd also like to point out how majestic the clapping of Billy Motion just was. He was very excited about the volunteers. If you could stand up and show
more of the talking.
As far as we know, Rocky Mountain doesn't have any more games scheduled before Westerns, which will be held in Richmond, not Oakland, in Richmond, California, which I hear is close to Oakland, but not actually Oakland.
That is true. Pixar is in Richmond. That's how fancy Richmond is compared to Oakland, apparently.
So Westerns, no doubt, will be an excellent tournament. Rocky Mountain's likely to fall a little bit from their current position of number two in the West. The rankings are released. They're imminent. We are patiently awaiting the public release. Philadelphia likely to stay where they are as they lost to Gotham and beat Charm City this year. So we're back in action now.
Hey, look at that. They're skating. V-Diva making her way out of the pack. She is out and lead jammer for Philly.
Top to Tonic tries to go outside. Nice clearing block from Anjan Minya, but heavy flow follows up and knocks Toxic Tonic almost to the outfield.
Yeah, Toxic Tonic still caught up in the pack, hasn't broken out, and V-Diva is about to score all of the points.
There's a lap point. One more is AJ. She goes outside, but AJ, nice hit. It is hard to take Vita out of bounds, but oh, AJ is going to go down.
Oh, wow.
And V-Diva is going to think about it and think about it and then call it. So Rocky's still with two in the box.
Good work by Toxic Tonic, though. She was able, even though she was caught up in the pack for a while, she was able to take advantage of the chaos that was happening as soon as V-Diva entered the pack and was able to make her way out. Unfortunately, V-Diva, very good skater, kept her wits about her, kept her eye on the opposing jammer, as you're supposed to do when you are a jammer, a lead jammer especially, and was able to call it before Rocky could score any more points. So Philadelphia at 43 to Rocky Mountains 34. Oh, look, another timeout. Oh, joy.
Looks like this might still be a Rocky Mountain panic communication, as we are still two in the box, and there might still be one person that needs to serve an upcoming penalty. So Rocky Mountain really in penalty trouble here. They had two the entire last game, still have two in the box, and may have somebody that needs to serve. Still waiting to see exactly what the situation is.
Take a number and wait in line.
Exactly. If you thought you heard ambient booing, you didn't. It was Team Cruise was cheering over there.
That's right, doing the Cruise chant.
We've got, looks like a Salt and Pepper and Make You Pay are the Rocky Mountain blockers. On the knees at the jammer line, it looks like Violet.
Who are these people?
Sorry, Castro. Right.
Who are these mysterious people?
I was thinking about Tempo. This means I'm old. Her name is now Castro. Also out there is our Damage Doll, who is a transfer to Philly from Steel City. And there are two other Philly blockers in position that we will definitely not see before the game starts.
It's really amazing to me just to see how many transfers between leagues a lot of teams in all of the regions seem to be experiencing, especially this season. Hey, look, they're skating.
And that is Castrator trying to get the lead for Rocky Mountain.
Trying to take advantage of Philly kind of taking themselves out. However, number 85, Teflon Donna, out and lead for Philly.
Now Castrator have a little bit of trouble in the front of the pack here. He's taken down and is now in danger. No, he's going to get out of the pack before Teflon Donna enters, and she sees nothing but red in the back. Tries to go outside, and now she's got a Salt and Pepper and Salt Sweet Mary Pain to beat. Here comes Castrator. Is she going to make it in time? Yes, she did pull up a few points there before Teflon Donna got the call. The crowd does not like that call. I think they felt that the Teflon was calling it off before the whistle actually blew, and that they felt the late call off may have ended it with Rocky Mountain getting some points that Teflon did not wish them to attain. So that lead will go to 8 points now. 30. I'm sorry, I can't do math either. 12. 12 points. Oh, and the score changed again on this. So now it's a 9-point lead. 30. 46 to 37, a very, very, very fast lead jammer call for B Devo, as Rocky Mountain still has two blockers in the box.
That seems to be their modus operandi for the latter half of this first period.
And off of the box of Sweet Mary Payne, Rocky Mountain being really rocked. Well, they didn't even say that. Rocky Mountain is being buffeted by blocker penalties.
That's right. Toxic Tonic still trying to make her way out of the pack, but Philly has the advantage with more, well, now they only have three blockers. How about that?
It's a Toxic Tonic trying to find a way through past the last blocker.
She finally gets a little friendly push out of the front of the pack by Free to Beater.
Now Rocky Mountain split up one-on-one. It's going to be a solemn time for V Diva through the middle.
Making it super easy for V Diva to pick up 4 points.
And Philly wants to keep going here. They want to get a block out of the box. They'll probably call it when she gets out. And yep, there it is. So Philly, playing that one smart, able to kill the time and start with the 4-4 pack. A Rocky Mountain still, for I think the third or fourth jam in a row, is going to start with two in the box, but they will have one standing at least.
That's right, Rocky Mountain at 37 points to Philly's 55. 7 minutes, 3 seconds left in the first period.
So this score actually surprisingly close, given the fact that Rocky has been playing shorthanded for the last 7-8 minutes. Once they get all four on the track back, you might expect to see the score a little bit closer, if that ever happens.
Well, I think more importantly, again, it's the jammer penalties. They're jammers. There's only been, one or two power jams in this game so far. And if that trend continues, it'll continue being a close game.
Philly out first, not lead jammer. Looks like a no pass, no penalty is being signaled by the referee. Oh, I'm sorry, minor track cut.
Minor cut, yes.
So if Castrator can make her way past the pivot here, she might be able to call it off. But
and again, Rocky hanging back at the back of the pack, again trying to get a no-pack call to get their own jammer out, but also being the first line of defense against Philly.
Bad news for Rocky Mountain. Oh. Major track cut for Castrator.
I feel like I jinxed them. It's a power jam for Philly.
Mopane off to the races. Philly's going to hang back and do the conga line in the back. Let's see if they choose to go to offense as Mopane enters.
Oh my gosh, are there four blockers on the track for Rocky?
Looks like Phil's going to sit there and wait and see what happens. And oh, and what happens
uh-oh.
Is
back block.
So that didn't work out too well for Philadelphia there.
Well, they're still in the lead. They're now up to 60 points against Rocky's 37. We'll see what happens with the musical jammer game we have going on.
Castrator, I think, is going to have to start over on her initial pass if she didn't finish it. Oh, okay, one Philly goes to the box. I was confused there for a second.
And it looks like a Salt and Pepper on her way to the box.
Now one to beat on as Philly tries to bridge.
Oh.
Now 25 seconds remain here for Castrator to try and put some points up here.
Rocky doing a good job of isolation slash goading technique in the back of the pack.
Failed apex jump, and she's going to get hit with a misconduct for blocking with her skates off the ground. That was a rough one. She tried to go for an apex jump, and that's why it's risky. If you initiate contact with her skates off the ground, you're going right back to the box. That's what happened to Castrator.
And again, the musical jammer game continues.
This jam is going to end right when Castrator sits in the box here, so it'll be interesting to see.
So it's prime time for Philly on this jam. They're going to be able to take a full advantage of this power jam.
Now, actually, I think we're going to see the most exciting part of Derby, a jam starting with neither jammer. I'm sorry, I was wrong. Because if she had made it back to the box, and the jam ended before she had sat down, then we would have had no jammer. But it looks like we will have. Philly getting a jammer off of the box. Or maybe not. They're talking over in infield here.
Oh, look, another timeout. 4 minutes, 34 seconds left in the first half of the game. Again, this is a full-length game tonight.
And Philly looks like they are expecting a power jam as they have all taken the very, very back corner straight away.
Sorry, making it very obvious that they're going to leave the outside wide open for their jammer to get through. That's a fun technique that I've been noticing a lot lately, too, especially here at RollerCon.
So Teflon Donna will return to the jammer line. And Rocky Mountain will still. Oh, nope.
They got three.
They got three.
Three
yeah.
whole blockers. That's more than two, so they're doing good.
They are improving their numbers here. We're going to see Frida Beater and
I think that's Gagan.
Yes. Gagan also transfer along with Sweet Mary Payne from the Chicago outfit. Score currently 64-37 with 4 minutes and 34 seconds remaining. If you are just joining us, we're watching a thrilling referee timeout. My name is Justice Feelgood Marshall.
And I am Tara Armoff.
And we are patient through this timeout.
Very, very patient.
It is actually one of the first things people think about when they think about these two, Justice Feelgood Marshall and Tara Armoff, well known for our patience.
And apparently interchangeable to some people.
Yes.
How that happens, I don't know. That particular drug combination must be very, very strong.
37 on the board for Rocky, 64 for Philly. So we were talking about this earlier in the first game. Is that I have got to say, of all the RollerCon venues I've seen, it's definitely the prettiest that I've ever seen RollerCon looking. This is a really good venue. The floor looks amazing. Unfortunately, I can't skate on it because I don't hurt my ankle, but it looks really good from up here. The colors, the layout is like great. Once we got the scoreboard working, everything was perfect.
And also, underneath this is the Razor Slut track that this game is happening on, and hopefully the audience at home can see that there is plywood on each corner where the sport court, I don't know the difference. To me, it's all skate sport court. And that is helping reinforce the floor and keep it in place, because as people may have heard last year at RollerCon, we had a lot of problems with the floor sliding.
Floor,
and
yes.
Yes, and there were several times when they had to totally reset the floor at night, at the end of the day and stuff. And this year, it looks like everything is staying in place. Yes. The tracks have been solid, and it's interesting. Some people think the tracks are really, really slippery. I think they're not, because my standard is the RollerCon from a few years ago at the Sports Center.
Oh, that RollerCon!
Oh my gosh!
That was a great weekend. The skating was very different than usual.
Yes, if you're a fan of Bambi on Ice, you would have loved that RollerCon.
The other thing I like about the plywood here is it makes it much easier to trip, which I have
done
so many times today.
Yes, yes, that has been rampant. Apparently, the little red stripes on there, not enough. It needs to be neon or something. I don't know. Hey, are they getting back to the game?
It appears that we might be seeing roller derby playing.
Oh, wow. That's so exciting. I love watching roller derby when it's actually happening.
I came all the way here to see some derby. Now I can get to. After 4 minutes of timeout, we're getting ready to go. Philly's still holding a pretty solid lead here, 64-37.
Sweet Mary Payne on the line for Rocky, making her way out on the outside, making it out, and lead jammer for Rocky.
And what's interesting here, that I believe that both jammers start on the jam line, even though it looked like both ended in the box. So a little confusion there is probably what they were talking about before 4 minutes.
That's probably what that timeout was about.
Yeah.
It's like, nuh-uh.
Sweet Mary Payne looking for points here as her lead jammer for Rocky Mountain around the outside. She's going to call it quickly here.
Yeah, just as Teflon Donna hits the back of the pack.
So that's Rocky Mountain's first points in a while. 4-0 for Rocky. And that's going to be 64-41. Still a fairly close game here. Kind of like the reverse of what we were seeing this morning when Rocky played Minnesota. Rocky Mountain is about 5 to 20 points ahead for the whole game. Right now, Philly's in the same position as we're counting down into the last 3.5 minutes of the first half here.
What I thought was interesting with the Rocky-Minnesota game was even though Rocky was in the lead most of the time, there were periods where, again, penalties kind of bit them, and Minnesota came very close at some points to catching up and overtaking them, but then Rocky would just squeak it out at the last minute and pull ahead. And
this is a lead jammer for Shanita Stretcher. And in a second here, we're going to see 5 people from each team in the track. Ooh, big ref trap door over there in the corner. Front of the pack here, 2 to beat for Castrator. He's knocked out very effectively, and a major track cut forced.
I think that was Shanita Stretcher that was able to pull that off for Philly.
I'm sorry, B Diva was jamming, and now she's going to the box, and Philadelphia loses a golden opportunity there. So Rocky Mountain gets lucky. They're getting it right back. B Diva should be returning any second now. That was a very short penalty for both.
And there she is.
So B Diva will be in a scoring pass, whereas Castrator is really having a hard time with Shanita Stretcher. She's all over her. And
B Diva just slides by on the outside.
And Castrator worked hard for that pass. But no points on it, as that was her initial pass, and B-Diva not coming for more. 69 for B-Diva, 69 for Philadelphia, 41 for Rocky Mountain. B-Diva will be putting some more points up here if she's able to get some offense here as a Philly is hanging out in the back. B-Diva's going to wait, and...
Oh, nice sideways move there. Kid hits out by AJ, has to reset behind AJ.
Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot that B-Diva went to the boxing in the gym. She was there for 5 seconds. So she lost lead at that point. My apologies.
Oops. Defense on both teams are really cranking up right now.
Shanita Stretcher was just owning that jam.
Until she got sent to the penalty box. Oops.
Owned it too hard.
Let it go, Shanita. Let it go.
So Philly's probably going to stay in the lead going into the half here. We have one more jam to go, well, perhaps two more, but likely one as we're going to start this last one with about 1:10 on the clock. We got 73 for Philadelphia, 45 for Rocky Mountain. Rocky Mountain now is a 4-on-2 blocker situation, so they might be able to get a good jam out of this one.
Toxitonic on the line for Rocky Mountain.
And they could really use a big one here, take them into halftime.
Toxitonic trying to take the outside, gets hit out in turn one, has to reset behind.
Philly's defense holding strong with just 2 here. But through and not going to get lead.
Minor track cut, it looks like.
Yeah. That is so. So if Rocky Mountain's 4 are able to hold long enough here, she might be able to get lead. Toxic around the outside. Oh, and she is going to go down hard. Unclear on if there was any penalty call on that.
All of the whistles and all of the land.
So Philly is going to call it. Rocky Mountain does not appear to have points going up on the board from that jam. Oh, there they are.
There they are.
So they get two. And there is a race right now between the period clock and the jam clock, or the jam countdown clock. Let's see which one wins.
Ooh, so exciting to watch this. Rocky Mountain at 47, Philly at 73.
1 second before the period ends, the jam starts, so we'll get one more in.
Wow, Sweet Mary Payne just taking the outside line, quickly getting lead jammer status for Rocky Mountain.
Philly now has one in the box as blocker, so that's going to be a 4-3 pack favoring Rocky Mountain. Stuck behind a salt and pepper, Amanda Jamadinha is Mo Payne. Off the inside, unseen, untouched.
Grand slam for Rocky Mountain.
AJ trying to hold the line here on Mo Payne.
It looks like Philly has decided to beat up on a salt and pepper for a while.
Once again,
and she doesn't notice. Oh, there she is. She's like, oh, okay, I'll figure out that Philly wall and mess stuff up.
Gets four more, calls it off. Rocky Mountain doing a good job of bridging in that game once again. So Rocky Mountain will make it a differently pointed game. A 17-point game, I believe we have here.
You and the math, gosh. That's right, Rocky Mountain at 56 to Philly's 73 at the half. We're going to take ourselves a little bit of a break. It looks like I think we have a 15-minute halftime. That's what it's generally been so far.
Yes, indeed. So we are going to take a break to refresh ourselves. We'll be back with you a few minutes before the half. Once again, you're listening to Justice Gilgan Marshall.
And Tara Armoff.
On W News Network for RollerCon 2012. See you in about 15.
I am thinking of the basketball.
John Manning just pointed something out very interesting to me. Apparently they are Philly, but apparently they like to fight.
It's true. All of the above are true.
Mic check 1-2 coming back from halftime.
Hear me, Tara?
Oh, you're not wearing headphones, so no, you can't hear me.
No, I can't.
Mic check 1-2.
I hear nothing. I see nothing. Oh, maybe if I turned around and face the track. Hey, there we go.
It is 73 for Philly, 56 for Rocky Mountain here. Rocky Mountain fell into some penalty trouble early, or pretty much all the first half, I should say. Working with two for at least 10 minutes there, but managed to keep it a fairly close game. And this jam will start with absolutely not a soul in the penalty box from either team.
Get a good look, folks. This may not happen again for the rest of this game.
Not only there are four on the track for each team, they are all very close to the pivot line.
Whoa, and they're all down on their knee. So this jam is going to start immediately, by gosh.
So Darius actually has some space to play with on the way to the back. Let's see what B-Diva and Sweet Mary Payne can do with it in, well, first let's wait 30 seconds as halftime comes to an end. And then maybe we'll start playing order.
Won't that be exciting? And welcome to RollerCon, everybody.
You know, it is cool. Helen Wheels down here, a little celebrity signing.
Helen Wheels skating for Rocky.
And the waiting. 10 seconds left.
10 seconds to the second half. Waited this long, waiting 5 more.
Giving us a shoulder wink.
And now we can do that thing where we skate in circles.
Yay!
5 more seconds. There we go.
Just when we think we're ready to go. Rocky's got their front wall going on.
V-Diva having a lot of trouble here with strong hits from Pepper there, but she is now out with Lee Jammer.
That's right. She did a little hop there on the inside past her own blocker. Was able to get out. Sweet Mary Payne trying to make her way through. V-Diva on her scoring pass. Almost there. She makes it out. 4 more points for Philly. Calls it off just as Sweet Mary Payne hit the pack. And a successfully shot out Rocky on that jam. Rocky remains at 56 points. Philly waiting for the update. 77.
Sorry, I had to take a second to locate my roster, which disappeared during halftime. But now it is back in my pocket.
Magically disappeared. And in that jam, two of Rocky blockers got penalties, so they're sitting in the box. Hey, didn't we see a lot of this in the first half? Yes, we did.
So it's going to leave Toxic Tonic with a tough situation here, 4-on-2 pack.
And
at the front of the pack here is number 99 of Meiji Pei, I believe, doing a good job holding up, but can't do it forever. Lee Jammer from Philadelphia. That is Teflon Don. Now, Toxic looking for some help here. Nice. Oh, man, Jammer came in for a offensive block. Didn't quite need to land it. And now
Rocky has to reconstitute themselves as Teflon Donna comes in on her scoring pass. She easily gets by the two Rocky blockers because they were not together.
Teflon Donna, plenty of real estate there to skate through. And now she's going to be able to put some more points on the board before Toxic Tonic is going to be able to get in scoring position.
Well, why not?
But Rocky, they're doing a good job in the front of the pack here. They're able to run away. Now Philadelphia is trying to decide their offense. Whips one up. That doesn't work either. Oh, it does work.
Oh, AJ going down. Both of them going down.
That really worked.
That works really well, apparently.
I spoke too soon.
Well, it worked in the fact that Philly putting more points on the board, increasing their lead. Hey, why not? I mean, this does. She did get a major, I do believe, for that. And no, maybe not. I lied.
I think that the block that she landed ended up knocking that Rocky Mountain player into the remaining one, and they both fell on that. So it was a hit to the back by the own player, so he was playing pinball with him.
What are you going to do? So the score is Rocky 56, Philly 86. That's 30 whole points.
It is 30 whole points.
Instead of 30 whole kittens.
And here comes BD looking for some more kittens right now. And they're stuck in the back here is Sweet Mary Payne trying to deal with Olivia Face.
And it doesn't help that Rocky, again, suffering from penalty trouble, as Salt and Peppa going to the penalty box. One less blocker in Rocky's arsenal for this jam.
Free to beat her alone at the front of the pack, and that is Gagan in the middle. Rocky Mona all stood up right now, trying to find a way to wall up.
Blah, 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 hanging back, trying to keep Philly as separated as possible.
So it looks like BD was not able to pick up Free to Beater's point as she was hanging out the front of the pack, but that does go 3-0 for Philadelphia, extending their lead to 33 points.
Looks like Castrator on the line for Rocky Mountain. And I do believe that is Mo Payne for Philly.
Once again, Rocky Mountain goes to the pivot line, and Philly is going to line up right in the center of the straightaway.
They start on the knee out of play, causing the jam to start immediately. Yay!
And now Mo Payne trying to find somewhere on the outside.
Oh!
There's one to beat, I think it's AJ. And she does it. Around AJ on the outside, lead jammer Mo Payne for Philadelphia.
Castrator trying to make her way past that last blocker in front, that last line of defense. She finally makes it out. However, Mo Payne about to start her scoring pass.
And Mo Payne runs into a lot of red and has to call it pretty quickly here. Let's see if she got anything. I'm not sure she did. Oh, I'm sorry. I think they're showing two, I think.
At least two. Three. She got three.
So back-to-back 3-0 again in Philadelphia. I'm going to extend the lead a little bit more.
56 points for Rocky, 92 for Philly. Toxitonic back on the line for Rocky.
Rocky Mountain still unable to really enjoy a pack of dominance.
But what's the fun of that? They obviously want to make it challenging for themselves. And they're doing a good job, by gosh.
They played a game this morning, so they won't rest in the penalty box tomorrow. Now, way in the back of the pack is Billy's jammer. That is Teflon Donna, but she's going to get around the outside. Lee Jammer, Philadelphia. And Lee Jammer starting, or Philadelphia starting, take control here. It's a bunch of Lee Jam calls in a row.
Yeah, Philly obviously gave themselves a really good pep talk because they've just come out swinging in this second half of the game.
Teflon Donna looking for points.
Ooh, make you pay going down in the back.
I thought the referee was making a penalty signal, but I believe he was just dancing. 95, so
yep.
just one more there.
Another three-point chance?
Correct, I cannot add. I've done three halves of announcing already. I've lost all my math skills.
I think it's because you're wearing shoes. You can't count on your toes to keep track of the points.
Here comes Sweet Mary Payne for Rocky Mountain. Trying to find something up the inside. Gets it. And lead jammer for the first time in a while is Rocky Mountain. One in the box for Philadelphia right now, so Rocky Mountain does enjoy the pack situation advantage. AJ and Gagan trying to bridge it out. But Gagan's going to lose her footing. And AJ puts a hit on Bidiva, not good enough to stop her, though. Sweet Mary Payne looking to finish off a four-point pass here.
Sorry, Rocky holding back, trying to get Philly's blockers out of play in the front, but she just decides to call it. It's like, meh.
Philly was able to keep her getting the full four there.
But Rocky does pick up 3 points, 59 for Rocky Mountain, 95 for Philly Liberty Bells.
The house announcers have just mentioned there was a palindrome on the board, and the crowd went wild.
Everyone high fives each other.
Everybody high five your neighbor. It's a palindrome.
Castrator jamming for Rocky Mountain. Makes it through. Lead jammer.
So once again, it's two in a row for Rocky Mountain.
V Diva still trying to make her way out of the pack, trying to get past AJ.
There's a Mo Payne out there right now.
Oh, I lied.
And then Jamania does to dish it past her, and Creed Beater goes to the box as Rocky Blocker. Once again, putting two Rocky Mountain Blockers in the penalty box. 4-on-2 situation favors Philadelphia. And really, really, really doesn't favor Castrator, who takes a hit to the inside and is going to call it off. Just do it in time. No points for Philly. Just one for Rocky. Philly won a tri-cut call on that, but did not get it.
Wah, wah.
Now counting down to just under 22 minutes left in the second and last game of Friday at RollerCon 2012. Earlier today, Rocky Mountain defeated Minnesota. They're now trying to come back on Philadelphia.
And, oh, shocking, Sweet Mary Payne back on the jammer line for Rocky.
And Teflon Donna, both teams going to strategy of putting out really good jammers.
Salt and Pepper and AJ, the only Rocky blockers on the track. Not enough to hold back Philly.
And now Sweet Mary Payne working against a big wall of blue and black here.
That's right, since Philly has a full complement of blockers on the track, her job is going to be a little bit difficult getting out of there.
Let's see what AJ and AJ and Peppa unable to stop past that time. They get one more out of the box to help out.
Yeah, and AJ is going to the box. Wah wah.
Make you pay is going to also go out. Rocky Mountain in a 4-on-1 situation right now. Penalty is absolutely destroying them.
Oh my goodness.
Now they get some more out of the box here as Frida is going to be released from the box just in time. But that still leaves us only two. And here comes Stefan Donna looking for some more points.
Sweet Mary Payne, she's still trying to get out of the pack. Kind of makes me wonder if it would have been better off, even though Rocky Mountain is behind, if she went on defense just to stop the bleeding a little bit.
Yeah, this is a nightmare jam right now for Rocky Mountain. As Teflon Donna has all day long, 40 seconds still in this jam, and Sweet Mary Payne is not broken yet, and it's very little help from a late pack.
Yeah, Philly has broken the century mark by now.
Teflon Donna trying to find a way through Peppa and Frida Beater and finds an inside line. Score keeps going on Philadelphia now at 107-18, I think, after this score update. We'll see. Yeah, 118-60.
Math well.
10 more seconds. She might be able to double up Rocky Mountain if she gets through on this one.
Oh, Teflon Donna taking the outside, finding the friendly side. Goes down. Due to her own skater, it looked like.
Sweet Mary Payne gets out, but off after about a minute and 55 seconds.
That's right. Rocky Mountain still stuck at 60 points to Philly's 118, I do believe.
Yes. So Rocky Mountain, and they do get doubled up here. Philadelphia now has doubled their score, 122-60. And now, looks like Philadelphia really in the driver's seat. They can afford to get a few big jams here and still have a lead.
Looks like Toxic Tonic back on the jammer line for Rocky Mountain. And oh my gosh, but look, the penalty box is empty for Rocky Mountain. This is good because they need all of their blockers. They need everybody on the track.
This must be a mistake.
This is an outrage.
Oh. And I guess they're trying to start the jam with no one in the box. Here's
that is a hell of a scrum start, yeah. I must say.
There are about 10 roller girls squashed into about 1 foot worth of space here.
Well, the air conditioning does get a little cold in here. Body warmth helps.
Geneva goes on the inside, one to beat as Amanda jammed in here. She is sucked back into the middle of the pack situation. Philly now with a one in the box. Neither jammer able to break after a full lap here. And finally, lead jammer is going to go to Rocky Mountain's Toxic Tonic. And man, do they need this call right now.
And Philly does have two blockers in the box. Well, actually, a blocker and a pivot. And Rocky really needs to capitalize on that. Greatly. They do.
Toxic calls. Not in time to keep Philly off the board.
But at least Rocky did pick up 4 points. They're up to 64.
So cut from the lead a little bit.
A little tiny bit.
There's still time to come back on small jams, but they have to win a lot of them at that rate. Rocky Mountain really.
And they have to stay out of the penalty box.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, my goodness, they have to stay out of the penalty box.
Rocky Mountain and Dopamine Opinions.
I'm very famous. Are you?
Wow, look at that. Everyone's near the pivot line. How exciting.
Jam starts once again favoring Rocky Mountain in the pack, 4-2. However, the remaining Philly blockers are able to suck back.
Castrator.
Oh, and Philadelphia getting a lead on a 4-2 pack.
Philly doing an excellent job keeping that pack at a standstill, making it easier to score more of the points.
Another Philly blocker on the way to the box. Now Philly on a one-on. Now Philly's turn to be 1-on-4.
Uh-oh. Now this is a power jam in favor of Philly. A backlock major. Oof.
Yeah, Rocky Mountain having a really, really hard time with the box tonight.
And it doesn't help that Shihu now going to the box for Rocky.
Philadelphia's going to go to the conga line in the back here. They're trying to keep, you can see them trying to keep Rocky from resetting behind them. And they're going to.
And they're just, hello, m'lady, go this way.
Just take their jacket off and throw on the floor for Rocky Mountain for Mo Payne to skate over.
Free Debater are trying to keep everything together as much as possible along with Rad Eye.
One thing Rocky Mountain is doing very well in this game is bridging out in the situations. Unfortunately, they're still getting no points, but they're managing to keep the power jam, or excuse me, keep those passes a little bit longer than we otherwise. You see right there in the back of the pack, the one bridge, number 30, Red Dye is bridging out, and now it's number 7 they are bridging out.
That's right, a salt and pepper, last line of defense. However, finding herself out of play. And Mo Payne's like, meh, I'll just call it. What the heck?
Rocky Mountain is surprisingly big hole now at halftime. Looked like it was truly anybody's game, but right now Philly is threatening to go up by 100 points and to get another couple good jams here.
That's right, Rocky Mountain at 64, Philly Liberty Bills 143. 15 minutes. 29 seconds left in this game.
You don't want to take anything away from the team that is winning by a lot. However, it seems that Rocky Mountain is not that they're playing badly, they're playing in a way that is leading to too many penalties. A 4-on-4 matchup is going to be a much, 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 much closer game, but having to work from a disadvantage almost all the time, Rocky Mountain falls into a big hole here.
Yes, it's a little frustrating that despite the lineup changes that have happened to Rocky in this past season, that unfortunately they're keeping the penalty count at the same level that they were before.
So it's like Philly's going to add a little bit. I'm sorry, Rocky Mountain got that one.
Oh. Apparently not.
I listened to the house announcer. Damn it. Not right the first time. Philadelphia gets a few more.
Yep, that's right. Rocky still at 64. Philly, 147. 14 minutes, 29 seconds left in the game. Free to Beater, Salt and Pepper, the only Rocky blockers on the track. They start on the pivot line.
Good job backward bridging there from Philadelphia as they force the Toxic Tonic even further back after getting forced out of bounds.
That's right. She had to start like 10 feet behind the jammer line.
She needs to stretch her ass to give up at the front of the pack here. I'm sorry. Damage doll. Not too bad.
Frida and Salt and Pepper doing a good job trying to keep that pack as fast as possible, making it a little bit harder for Philly to score, but they're still scoring all of the points.
One to beat is Salt and Pepper, but getting through, and she is going to think about it.
If I were Rocky, I'd be calling a timeout by about now.
Yeah, Rocky Mountain definitely is going to need to turn it around in a huge way right now, or it's going to be a Philly blowout.
Rocky Mountain at 64 points to Philly's 151. My goodness. Everyone starting on a knee. Always cracks me up when both teams start on a knee. It's like we want to make damn sure that this chance starts.
Part of the pack here is Rocky Mountain's jammer being. Oh, but.
V-Diva out and lead jammer for Philly. Goodness.
No luck for Castrator now as the front of the pack is all blue. Rocky Mountain tries to run up and play offense. It's AJ right now, tries to pick off the Philly pivot.
It looks like Rocky was a little bit split between trying to get a no-pack call by hanging in the back and then trying to go up and assist. AJ's like, screw it, let's try an assist. And everyone else is like, no, we'll just hang back. And that's not really working out for Rocky right now.
V-Diva, though, trying to do a spin move because cuts the weight of the box. Rocky Mountain really, really needs to stay on turnaround right now as they have power jam. But they're having cast traders getting hammered.
And not in a good way.
Wow.
Castrator finally making it out. Rocky doing their job, trying to, they're literally having the pack at a standstill.
Now, Rocky Mountain does play offense here. They run up, but, and now they're going to fall back and leave one playing offense. And this is not actually so hot for Rocky, as three were hanging back and just letting one beat up in the front.
Yeah, Shihu was the only one that went up, and unfortunately, she made the pack move forward because she defined the pack.
Right.
And
clockwise major, I think, is being called on Philadelphia's Olivia Face goes to the box. And now we have Castrator once again on the backs of Philadelphia attempting to...
Oh, wow. That was uber violent. It's like, what? What? What are you going to do? What? Wow. You're going to get by me for a point? What?
Lots of big shoulder hits right to the sternum, but Castrator is going to suck it up and keep going. She has 8 seconds now to get some more points for Rocky, which they desperately need.
And she's doing her best. She's hanging in there.
Let's see if she's able to pick any more off there.
Yeah, Rocky.
To get to.
Rocky probably could have gone one-on-one on that last pass to try and break up Philly. I think that's the thing. It's like Philly's doing an excellent job of staying together in their defensive walls. Rocky, when they're together, they're stopping Philly great. But unfortunately, they tend to break off and splinter off and do different things.
There have been a few times where we've seen the Philly Jammers get to do a cone drill.
Yes.
Replacing Rocky Mountains. And now it is
Sweet Mary Payne.
Quickly jam recall there.
AJ shutting down Philly's jam very effectively. Look at that. However, she pushes herself out of play doing so.
Oh, and also about Kaiser cycle in the back and ends up running into her own jammer.
Oops.
And Sweet Mary Payne's going to need to call this real fast. And she does. Don't know if she got it in time. Looks like she did. I don't think any points totally on that one. So Rocky's a little bit of rally going on here. We have 2 minutes left to try and keep going with it.
Yeah, they're up to 80 points against Philly's 154.
So Rocky's going to once again take a knee way up at the pivot line. It seems so far away these days.
It's like a faraway land.
So the Rocky Mountain fans in the audience are trying to get the fans pumped up with some clapping. Very, very slow, tight storm right here.
Yes, I said Alpha.
Yeah, this is the first time we've seen Alpha jam in this game tonight.
Alpha tries to get outside. She gets lead, but at the same time is knocked out of bounds. So has to come back behind. However, she will get through. After it took a little while to get out of pack there after that hit. Oh, a big hit from Amanda Jamadinha. AJ has absolutely been a standout in this game.
Yeah, when AJ is on, she is very, very on.
Oh, this is interesting. That Billy Jammer didn't know whether or not that the other players out of play and came back, she didn't need to. So that's going to allow Alpha to get that full pass and get a chance for more.
And unfortunately, Toxic Tonic on her way to the penalty box. Putting Rocky again at a disadvantage in the pack.
Alpha calls just in time, but cannot add any more points on that one. So Rocky does manage to get a few more points, but now, as they say, the clock is the enemy.
Is that what they say?
Yes. Time is not their friend.
They're also offering glitter arm numbers. You like glitter?
About 8 minutes and 14 seconds left on the enemy right now. As looks like Castrator again jamming for Rocky Mountain and V Diva out there for Philadelphia.
V Diva looking like she's trying to take the inside. Squeaks by on the inside. Gets out and is lead jammer for Philly.
Frida has to slow down. It's 20 feet away. Now Castrator will get out, but V Diva's got about a half a track lead. It's probably going to extend it because she's kind of fast.
Rocky doing their best to speed up that pack as much as possible, which is definitely what they want to do. However, Philly using the goading isolation technique, holding back one of Rocky's blockers to define the pack in the back, making it easier for V Diva to score. V Diva says she gets 4 points. We'll see if the refs agree.
Yeah, that was a nice job. I think that was Amanda Jamadinha was able. I'm sorry, not Amanda Jamadinha. She's on a different team. It was Shanita Stretcher.
AJ just plays for everybody, apparently.
Exactly. Shanita Stretcher on Gagan on that was very effective in making her a part of the pack in the back, and that's why they got those points.
Okay, looks like Rocky's still at 85 points against Philly's 158. 7 minutes, 2 seconds left in this game.
Much needed lead jammer call for Rocky Mountain Sweet Mary Payne. And a 3-on-3 pack right now.
Rocky really needs to keep that pack slow as possible. AJ doing an excellent job holding back Philly's jammer just as Sweet Mary Payne hits the pack on her first scoring pass.
She'll call this one off pretty quickly here. Picking up 3 more points, looks like. Hard to tell from here, as always.
She did. She picked up 3 more points.
Excellent. My eyes aren't that bad.
You can still do math. It's all good. Rocky almost on the pivot line, taking a knee. Looks like it's a 3-on-3 pack. However, Rocky about to get their 4th blocker back into the game. She is standing in the penalty box, which means she has less than 10 seconds left on her penalty time.
Rocky will get their blocker out of the box first, but will it happen before Teflon get out of the pack? Oh, big ball here.
That's Alpha. Second time jamming in this game. Getting caught up with a 2-wall by Philly in the front.
Nice recycling by Philadelphia.
Excellent recycling.
Alpha is out without lead. Looks like she had minor.
That was a definitely a minor track cut.
Yeah.
Even I saw that.
Now desperately trying to grab points before Teflon. Oh, I can get lead jammer on 1 foot. But now she can't call it off.
Oh, my goodness.
And she does call it off.
Yeah, she shut it down.
And again, since scoring happens through the 4th whistle when a jammer's trying to call it off, Alpha just kept going. She's like, screw it. Let's see what I can do. And she bumps up Rocky's score to 92 against Philly's 158.
Now, Rocky Mountain definitely going to need, or would be much help, I should say, by a big power jam in this last 5 minutes. It's going to be really hard to come back with both jammers on the track.
Yes, again, as we have noted before, when both jammers are on the track, we have some relatively low-scoring jams for both teams. Oh, we got the biggest scrum ever. B Diva fighting her way through, making it out, and lead jammer for Philly.
On the way to the box is Heavy Flow for Philadelphia. And now Rocky Mountain's going to define the pack in the back. Unfortunately, that's right where B Diva is, and he's coming in for points.
And it looks like Castrator making her way out of the pack for Rocky.
Nice dodge by B Diva. Gets around AJ. You see V Diva saying, let's run this jam up a little while. Waits and calls it, and that's the jam. I would like to see how many jams of this game AJ has played in. I'll say pretty close to 110.
Yeah, she's definitely hanging in there a lot in this game.
She's been, it looks like she's going basically like maybe 5 in a row. She is sitting this one out, but it seems like they're definitely not taking her off on a regular basis. And why not? Because she's kind of good at rolling.
Kind of. She's kind of a big deal.
Sweet Mary Payne and Mo Payne, Pain on Pain.
All of the pain on the track.
It looks like Rocky Mountain's pretty much out of luck in this one. Got 70-point differential makeup.
Oh, especially,
Now they're even further out of luck. Losing their jammer, Sweet Mary Payne, to the penalty box.
Mo Payne just saying, all right, fine. I don't care. Yeah, I'll get by you. I'll take my time. It's cool. Yeah, whatever, free to beat her.
Working on both red die and free to beat her, and Rocky Mountain doesn't have enough players to bridge because there are only 2 of them out there. So here comes Mo Payne, just looking to pad the margin of victory a little bit here. This is a big, big win.
Oh, nice little butt bump there. Easy 5 points for Philly.
And he's going to go for more here as just two out there. Red die. Frida Beater. Frida Beater gets out of bounds. Tries to run back. Philadelphia says no.
No. You cannot has.
Wow. Oh, no. And Frida's going to go to the box with a clockwise engagement.
Oh, wow. No. This is not what Rocky needs right now.
For the third time in the game there, it was once again a four-on-one situation there, but Rocky gets one more out of the box.
Yeah, the two lone blockers on the track trying to hold it together for Rocky. However, oh, look at this.
And it looks
oh,
like
a back block. Back block major.
So that'll put Sweet Mary Payne back on the track. But now,
it's interesting that Sweet Mary Payne is kind of taking her time because, all right, there is a huge point deficit, and I get that, but it's like, hurry up, get the points.
Not much time left here in this jam. Might not be able to get around again, but since the pack is not moving, it'll be easier. 9 seconds left. She's going to come up the inside.
Very well, I might
bangs her way through.
Nice.
And that will end the jam with a minute 40 left in the game. So we'll get at least one, maybe two more jams out of this. But no matter what happens, well, okay, I should never say that. It is extraordinarily unlikely that anything but a Philly victory will occur.
That's right, especially since Rocky is at 97 points. They have not broken the century mark yet, while Philly has 172. Now, anything could be possible. I mean, Alpha could score all of the points and all of the land if Rocky somehow manages to make the pack go backwards, I guess? I don't know. Have some kind of Superman time continuum interruption going on?
Well, they're on their way. They have lead jam.
That's a start.
But just under a minute left on the period clock. And
facing a tough Philly three wall there. She does make it through. That's five more points.
Rocky Brown goes to the conga line here.
Oh, my gosh. Up, Rocky has all the blockers. Look.
That's true.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
And once again, the only one plays offense, and they're going to fall back, and they're going to capture the Philly jammer. In doing so, I think they split the pack and said, yep, says Olivia face to the box, followed by Mankipe.
Yeah, we have blockers going to the box, one for each team. So it's a three-on-three pack. Alpha trying to take the inside, trying to find the friendly side, squeaking her way through.
So let's see if Rocky goes for the Hail Mary of call and call a timeout. I don't think they're going to do that.
Nah.
Yeah.
Heck with it.
I think they're ready for the other side of RollerCon.
The dark side of RollerCon. Nice little hop there by Alpha. Getting through for another 4 points. Oh, she decides to call it. However, the period clock had run out.
And that is a big, big win for Philadelphia. Not what many people expected going into this one. 172-116, unofficial final. As
everyone stands in front of the projection screen, so if there's a score update, we can't see it.
You can see somebody's shoulder in silhouette. We're waiting to see if it updates to an official final. Roller Derby. As the scoreboard is becoming more and more obscured by somebody with dreads, I think. Okay, there we go. Now I can see it again. Still on the official final. Still showing 172.
Well, it is safe to say that Philly won this one.
Yes. It would take quite a smoking the air to put this one in question. So, pending further information, we're going to call this game 172 Philly, 116 Rocky Mountain. Thank you for joining us on the second game of RollerCon 2012. Tomorrow, there are more games.
That's right. We have Denver playing tomorrow, as well as Philly again, right?
That's correct.
That's the 7 p.m. game tomorrow night, I do believe, Denver versus Philly.
Yes, okay. So we've got the lineup here. 12:15 Pacific time, Rose City and Philadelphia. 3:15, Philadelphia versus Minnesota. So Philly playing almost back-to-back there. And 7 p.m., Rose City versus Denver, DNN 2 versus DNN 3, so that would be a real corker there. And the Sunday game, Denver versus Minnesota at 12:15 Pacific. I would like, once again, to thank all of you, and especially thank my lovely and patient co-host, Tara Olov.
This has been an awesome time calling with you, Justice Feelgood Marshall.
Thank you very much, and I hope to see you at DNN tomorrow for the Fall 15 game. We will see you then. Thank you, and good night.
Goodbye.